My name is Vitaly, and I'm engineer on Facebook's Pytorch team. Today, I'm going to talk about our approach to Pytorch data loading. There are three topics I want to cover: the current state of the data loading, new data pipes concept, and new features we are planning to introduce. First of all, let's quickly cover Pytorch dataset as it is now. Usually, dataset is implemented as large self-contained class which covers all functionality, starting from disk loading down to various data transformations. It is commonly done with a random access pattern, so-called map dataset, leading to various memory usage problems. The number of problems is multiplied by the data loader implementation as it makes per worker process copy of dataset objects. Besides that, data loader is overloaded with built-in functionality like batching, collation, and shuffle, making these functions hard to extend and data loader hard to maintain. As Pytorch developers, we strongly believe that decomposing dataset to data pipes and updating data loader is the way to prevent such issues. So, what is a data pipe and how it is different from dataset we're all familiar with? Data pipe is map style or iter style building block, which contains basic functionality like loading, data transformation, decoding, and flow control. Dataset is represented as graph of data pipes nodes. For example, image folder dataset becomes a sequence of data pipes like file lister, file loader, image decoder, etc. Such approach allows us to replace any part of dataset without copy-pasting the remaining code. It is a good way to encourage code reusability. For example, disk reading dataset becomes web storage-based with the change of several lines highlighted bold in this slide. To simplify dataset development, we also add in a functional API to construct the data pipes graph as more intuitive and familiar to developers. But be sure that both types of syntax, class-based and functional-based, are going to be supported and maintained moving forward. When it comes to writing a new data pipe, it is as easy as simple class with an iterator. So you can always add your own storage to the existing dataset solution you like. But in most cases, it is not necessary to write data pipes as we provide large collection of ready-to-use solutions. Map function, filtering, batching operations, shuffle, flow control, and many others are already available in our code base. And Pytorch data repo keeps growing with community-written pipes to read and process the data. With all these changes, iterable data pipe becomes first-class citizen, allowing you to develop solutions for extra large datasets and preserve memory. But do not worry if you're a fan of map dataset, as map data pipe is also available. On top of the introduction of data pipes, we are also working on the new data loader. Multiple functions are getting moved from data loader to data pipes to increase extensibility. Things like batching, collation, shuffle are getting relocated. Such separation allows changing the order and behavior of the operations, as you can operate on mini batches in the middle of the pipeline or do other things. With decomposition of dataset to multiple smaller pieces, we can run different sections as separate processes or threads. Some pipes can be marked as single instance only when others run in parallel. Such approach allows you to get more control over memory usage and system load. And it also helps to solve problems like dropping partial batches. New data loader and data pipes are also receiving such features as automatic data sharding. Sharding can be applied externally to any data pipe or be data pipe's property, as it's done for all built-in pipes. To increase adoption, we even partition sharding to the existing data loader. In addition to the features already available in nightly builds of PyTorch and Torch data, we are looking forward to introduce more functionality. Fault tolerance and state restoration are currently under development and coming up next half. It is also tied up with randomness and determinism control, so expect to hear about them soon. With coming up TorchR integration, we are going to ship seamless syntax transition between data pipes and data frames world. This integration aims to simplify development as well as increase performance by solving serialization and batch processing problems. We are also looking to improve our distributed training and data loading picture by introducing heterogeneous cluster support when different nodes can take responsibility for data pre-processing without graph changes. To learn more about these updates and try them, please refer to the following resources: PyTorch Nightly Builds and Main Branch on GitHub for core data pipes and new data loader, Torch Data Repository for collection of data pipes, docs, and tutorials, and Torch Vision, Torch Text libraries for implementation examples. Thank you very much for watching.